I mean, this game is it's really everything, you know. I mean, I've been thinking about it all day and really all week, well, the last couple of days, especially now that we just got done with our last victory. But, I mean, whatever you do in this game is immortalized forever, you know. I mean, if you go for three touchdowns or you have however many tackles or you have however many sacks, everybody's going to remember this for really forever. So, you know, this game is just, it means a lot to us, and it means even more to us seniors.
It's a different week, too. You walk around, the M's are blocked out. I mean, what's this week like with all that stuff?
I mean, there's obviously a lot of stuff going on campus, and at times it's hard to stay focused. But, I mean, it just goes to show you how much the fans and the students have our backs. You know, I just went to class, and I'm walking in my building, and I don't see any M's on any of the building names or any of the signs or anything. I mean, it just kind of goes to show the severity of, I guess, our hatred for them.
But that's here. Urban's ordered all that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, I mean, it's universal throughout the entire campus.
I mean, they're having a tough year, obviously, and 5-6. But is there anything that you could ever imagine that would – make this game anything but a huge game?
You guys said one more time?
Yeah, is there anything that could happen to one of the schools in which they could collapse, essentially? And it still is not the game. Is it still always going to be as big as Ohio State, Michigan, no matter what circumstances there are in that given season?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely tough with them not having the season, obviously, that they wanted to. But, you know, we know every time we go into this game, we are going to get their absolute best. I mean, whatever we watch on film, we're going to see 10 times better effort, you know. I mean, they got good players, and obviously they haven't put it together that well this year. But, I mean, when we go out there, it's going to be a battle. It's going to be one of the toughest, if not the most physical game that we will play, just because of the rivalry, because of the animosity for each other, you know what I mean? So it's difficult to watch film because you know when you play them it's going to be a complete different attitude and really just kind of like a feel for the game.
That pressure that you talked about that goes with this game earlier, how do you make sure that brings out the best in your game as opposed to the worst?
I mean, that kind of goes with really all the games. I mean, all the games, it's really about how you can handle that pressure and then turn that into your own personal success or your own success as a team. So, I mean, it's just a way to manage the pressure and turn it in for a good thing for you, I guess.
What
happens to
defense?
You the first time you see him come out to the field, those helmets, that uniform? I mean, what goes on in your head?
Well, personally, I've, like you said earlier, I've grown to not like them very much ever since birth, you know. So every time I see, every time I hear that fight song, every time I see those damn helmets, I just, not great feelings come up, I guess.
Anger?
A little bit. But at least I get to get all that out for the last time this Saturday.
Why do you not like them so much, though? What is the, except that, you know, you've been raised that way and told to not like them, what is it that you don't like about them?
I mean, everything, really. I mean, I can't really put one thing on.
Does it take a little bit of the fact that you guys know that after this game you're going to the Big Ten championship game? Does that make this week almost a little bit easier for you guys to prepare for this game?
I don't know if it makes it easier. I mean, we know that we got to prepare as well as we have for any game, you know. I mean, like I said earlier, they're going to come out and give us their best swing. So we got to be able to take it and then give ours back, you know what I'm saying? So, I obviously feel that if we go out there and do what we need to do, it'll definitely work, bode well for us. But on the same token, I mean, they got good players, you know. They're a tough football team, and we're going to see all of that this Saturday.
At the beginning of the year, Urban said that you guys needed to find 100 yards of offense. Losing Braxton, you needed to find 100 yards of offense. Are you surprised that JT alone has made up for what you lost in Braxton?
I don't know. I wouldn't say surprised because, I mean, we went through camp with him all year, you know. I mean, or all summer, and working out with him in the spring, and we all just kind of got comfortable with him. We knew how he played. We knew what he was good at, and then once we got to the season, it was just a matter of getting experience together. And now that we've all been doing well together, we've been thriving as an offense, and we've been succeeding as a team. I guess our confidence was always there. We just kind of needed to go to battle together in order for for everybody else to see it.
Is there anything about his game that surprised you, though? His running ability or his ability to make plays with his feet? Is there anything about his game that has sort of surprised you?
No, I mean, we all knew he was a dynamic quarterback, a dynamic threat. I mean, play specifically, I guess I was a little surprised that he broke that one in Minnesota. I definitely thought he may have gotten caught, but I'm not going to talk about JT's speed because I love the kid to death, but we got to laugh about it later on, I guess. But nothing about his game really surprised me. I knew he was a warrior. I knew he was going to compete, and I knew that he really cared about this team, this university.
What do you have to say to him, you think, Saturday, if at all? One word of advice to calm him down or maybe even psych him up a little bit? Sometimes he seems pretty placid. But what would be your advice to him going into this game?
I mean, this, like I said earlier, this is the biggest game this season every year, no matter what, because of the way that we play each other, the way how hard the hits are, you know, just how important that every play is in this game, because it is so important to us. It is so important to our history, and it is so important to our personal season success. And I just say, just kind of calm down and do what we do. You know, we've been placed in pressure situations, and we've succeeded all year. So I mean, there's nothing out of the ordinary that we need to do. Nothing extraordinary. We just need to go out and do us.
To be considered one of the great quarterbacks in high state history, do you have to beat Michigan?
Absolutely.
Sometime.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And why do you say that?
I mean, it's just that's how everybody defined at Ohio State. I mean, you think of, oh yeah, well, we did this year, we did that year, and then the final question is always, well, what was your record against them? You know, and I mean, I think that's kind of like a defining, especially at this university, a defining characteristic of a player.
Evan, with everything they've been put through, what they've been through this year, 5-6, they need to beat you guys to get bowl eligible, and then the whole stuff with Brady that's going on up there. How desperate do you think they will be coming in here Saturday?
I mean, they're going to come out swinging. I'll be the first one to tell you that. I mean, I watched them all year, and I mean, they're a good football team. They got athletes, and they got mismatch problems for everybody that they play. But at the same time, I mean, I like our checkers better than theirs, and we're going to match or surpass their toughness and go out and handle the business that we got to take care of.
Evan, you guys have had issues with turnovers the last couple weeks. The one went off your hands. I mean, is it hard to – I mean, it's easy to say, well, eliminate turnovers. You can't do that. I mean, but is there an extra focus? What do you – how do you try to eliminate turnovers?
I mean, we just got to place a big emphasis on it this weekend. I mean, and we have the last 2 weeks ever since that it's kind of become an issue, and we're going to get it fixed, you know. Me personally, I'm gonna do whatever I can to make sure I get it fixed, and then I'm gonna just try to permeate that through the rest of the team. Like, hey, this is where, I mean, we're shooting ourselves in the foot most of the time. I mean, more often than not, we're stopping ourselves in drives as opposed to them stopping us, if that makes sense. So we just gotta eliminate that, because we know that we're a great offense, and without these turnovers, it'll be, I mean, even better.
When you see how many different ways Jalen gets the ball in terms of, you know, from the H-back position, you almost wish you got to play that position as well.
Yeah, but I mean, I also like the position I'm at, you know. I get to do some things that he doesn't get to do. I mean, but I mean, yeah, there's a lot of cool things that that our H gets to do, and I think that he suits everything that we ask him to do there very well. I mean, he's a strong kid, he's fast, and he can do anything that you ask him to do.
Who would have the harsher punishment for you for using the word Michigan, your dad or Urban?
Coach Meyer, definitely. I mean, we, me and my dad, obviously, we don't think too fondly of them, but I think Coach Meyer would have maybe a hand up on that one.
Was he Coach Iyer this week, by the way? Is he Coach Iyer?
Oh no! I guess if you want to think about it like that,
what is the punishment if you say that word?
Well, I'm sure the conversation that you'd get following wouldn't be too comfortable, and I'm sure in the weight room there'd probably be some kind of physical punishment or something, or whether it's push-ups or whatever. But I'm just gonna avoid it at all costs, so I'm gonna have to find out.
How has your view of this rivalry changed since playing in it?
It definitely gives me a different perspective. Growing up, just watching it on TV, obviously it was never really, like, I never really liked them very much, and I'm sure they felt the same towards us. I mean, I went up there a couple of times as a young kid, and just I mean, I don't like to play, so I'm glad I don't have to go back to Ann Arbor, and I don't plan on ever going back. And I'm going to do whatever I can to beat them up pretty good this week and go out 3-1 against them.